Okay, we can start off right now if everybody is in, right? So we'll not delay further. Wish you all the best. You are going to do your best today. You're all confident, I know. We had a very good practice last week and you must have done your practice. So here we start, okay?
This will be the Dharavik Malakshana, memory, bhavam, pronunciation.
So there will be three parameters. One is memorization. We had planned for one shloka. One shloka you will all memorize and tell. And the second, if you are unable to memorize, then we will give one shloka. You are going to recite that. Okay. So for that, we will have one smaranam, memory. And second, bhavam, the expression, how you are expressing. Okay. And the third is the correct pronunciation. Okay. These are the three parameters. You are going to receive marks. Okay, and the marks will be told to you after one day. Okay, we'll all put it on the group after one day. We'll put it up. Sunday evening. We'll put that cutoff mark because Anna has a lot of work. Okay, and we will have to just discuss and we will put it. Okay, that will be the process.
Most important thing which I want to tell before you all start is don't take this as a test or an exam. Think that this is a class and you are singing in front of the Lord, and you are fortunate, all of you are fortunate to learn the Gita. Gita is not a religious text, it has some universal messages for all people in the world. So we are fortunate to read the universal message, and which is the Vedic message. And let us not think it as a religious text. So you are just think that you are part of the nature, trying to spread this universal message of the Gita. Forget that this is a test.
And don't forget the test, the text.
Yeah.
Forget the test, but don't forget the text.
Right. Радха, готова ли ты нам что-нибудь исполнить?
Да, я не уверена, меня видно и слышно или нет?
Тебя слышно, даже если не видно, это не имеет никакого значения, но, в общем... Пожалуйста, нам что-нибудь для начала, если даже не из Гиты, то на твое усмотрение.
Конечно. Ну, могу и из Гиты, и не из Гиты то, что я знаю, не знаю. И да, это все в более северно-индийской школе индийского вокала. Яда, яда, хидхармасья. Lanir bhavati bharata abhyuthanam dharmasya tadatmanam srijamyaham paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha dushkritam dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. Это Гита. Могу еще наизусть один стих из Бхагавата Пураны пропеть в другом размере. Это был Анустуб, другой размер сразу спою. Мэйвам бибхорхати матам гадитум решамсам стантьяджа сарва вишаян става. Padamulat Bhaktan Bhajasva Duravagraha Matya Jasma Devo Yathadi Purusho Bhajate Mumukshu. Вот и все. Спасибо.
Спасибо.
Very good. Thank you so much. That's nice rendering. Thank you so much.
Are we ready?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes, we are ready. First, you can call.
First is Olga there.
Mark?
Yes, should I call her?
Yes, we can start.
Okay, Оля Желтые Уши, ты первая.
Хариом.
Хариом.
So should she tell what she remembers? Didi, what order do you want it to be?
So the first memorized shloka. And we will test if the shloka is memorized already, we will test the pronunciation in the same shloka. If Anna wishes, we will ask for one more shloka. So that will be.
Okay. Тогда, Оль, то, что выучила, то и сейчас зачитай.
Ой, а нужно вот зачитать вот эту предварительную мантру перед...
Нет, предварительную тебе читать не надо. Тебе надо зачитать только ту одну, которую ты выучила.
Да, это первое. This is the first Hariom. This is the first shloka. Arjuna uvacha yesha stravidhi mutsrijya yajante shradhayan vitaha tesham nishthatuka krishna Sattvamaho Rajastamaha.
It is visible.
You can hear it. Then I can't. Yeah, she has read.
Okay. So.
First
meaning more.
Meaning more.
The first shloka. First line. Can you repeat once more?
Arjuna uvacha. Arjuna uvacha.
Yes, continue.
Yesha. Yesha stravidhi mutsrijyan yajante shraddhayan vita. Tesham nishtha tuha krishna sattva maho rajastamaha.
This is excellent and better than the previous recitation. It has come out very well. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. And I can recite another shloka by your choice.
Yeah. How many shlokas?
Nine shlokas.
Nine.
Ayu sattva.
Oh.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. This is eight.
Eight.
Oh, very difficult. Ayu sattva balarogya sukha pritivi vardhanaha rasyaha snig Dhahasthira hrdya ahara sattvika priyaha.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
I can't believe it, Vega. You got the most upright one and you are taking the first chance. I'm very happy. It's wonderful change in you.
Hariom, thank you, Usha.
Good.
Usha, is she done?
Yes, hers is complete. Yes.
Okay, she is free.
Yeah, we can call her second.
So much thank you.
Then we are asking for Anatoly.
Anatoly, we can't see you. Please make your camera visible.
He can be seen, but the problem is that Skype seems not to handle all those videos at once. Okay. So sometimes some are not shown, but I see him.
Okay, fine, fine. Sure.
No. I'm ready, Usha.
Yeah, sure. You can. Please.
So you can
what's the memorized shloka?
Two shloka.
Second, okay.
Please. Second shloka, yes. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Trividha Bhavati Shraddha Dehinam Sasvabhavaja Sattviki Rajasi Chaiva Tamasi Cheti Tam Shrunu
Sattviki Dhirga Hinastra.
So one more time.
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Trividha Bhavati Shraddha Dehinam Sa Svabha Vaja Sattviki Rajasi Chaiva Tamasi Cheti Tam Shrunu.
Okay.
Hmm.
So next shloka you can ask anyone.
Ah. Ashastravihitam ghoram.
Ashastravihitam ghoram. Tapyante ye tapo janaha dambha. Ankara samyuktaha kamara gabalan vitaha.
Okay. If it is better, I think the marks we can tell later, but if there are some pronunciation related aspects, it is better to tell. Mark, can we tell it?
Yes, sure.
So
yes,
after yes. We will not forget because we will forget as who has told what at all, we will forget.
Right, exactly.
So, which is why I thought we should give the feedback on the pronunciation aspect before itself.
Sure.
That is, as soon as the recitation is over.
Right.
Okay. So, with respect to Anatoly, the bhava or expression is perfect. He has really done it well. From the pronunciation aspect, the second one, for example, Sattviki, that ki is a dirgha, is a long vowel. So it has a long vowel along with that consonant. So it needs to have two matras for pronunciation, which means it needs to be slight elongated. So, and the sattvi, that ikara before ka, along with the ta and va, is a short vowel and it has to have only one matra. That difference is not perceptible in the pronunciation of Anatoly. Other letters are pronounced very well. The Mahaprana Trividha is pronounced very well. Swabhavaja Mahaprana pronounced very well. Shraddha Dirga is pronounced very well. So only the Dirga in the Ikara, Sattviki in that word, can be improved, is my suggestion.
He left some small space for improvement, not to make it perfect at once. So we have something to speak about at least.
Thank you, that is great. And in the second shloka that he recited, Anatoly, Ashastra Vitanko, Tapyante, that Tapyante can be slightly better. Dambhahankara Sayuktaha. That Sayuktaha can be better. That's all. These are the two suggestions for Anatoly.
And from my side, Dambha, that Ashastra Vihi Tan Ghoram, the na was heard, Anatoly, it was not na. And the second thing, you were stopping, pausing in between the words, which was not proper. You other times you recite without that pauses. Okay, so I think it was the exam effect, right? Otherwise, you are perfect. You do it very well.
Right.
Yeah. And tapyante, that was missing. That tap after that we had, but that pause should have come there for the weight. That did not fall. That was the only thing. Okay. So don't worry about the marks, and it's not about the marks. Okay. It's about your participation. I'm very happy. The others who haven't participated, they are missing this nice occasion, right? So
exactly. So guess we are ready to move on to Yana.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Before we go. For Vega also, I would like to give the feedback because we will forget it later.
Yeah. Оля, про тебя.
For I'm unable to see. Vega, where is she? Okay, Vega. Vega. Yeah. Vega, Bhagini, Vega sister. The first one was Arjun. Arjuna Uvacha, when you pronounce Arjuna Uvacha, I heard it as Arjuna Uvacha. So Arjuna in Sanskrit will mean two Arjunas. So we should be careful. We have to really pause there and tell Arjuna Uvacha. That was the first comment. The first time you didn't tell the Mahaprana, but second instance you told everything correctly. The first time was not good, but the second time everything was okay. Shastra Vidhimut Srijya Shraddhayan Vitaha Visarga. So what you told nicely in the first time was Tesham Nishthatu Ka Krishna. Mahaprana was done nicely. The Shakara Nishtha. The Shakara was done very nicely. Yeah, it was done perfect. Krishna, it was not Krishna. You did Krishna. You did it correctly. So those two was, there are some good points. Other things were perfect. Arjuna Vacha is one of the main point.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I remember.
Yeah. And my side, Ye Shastra, that was the Mahaprana, or the
Dirga. Dirga. Ye Shastra. So first, so it is Ye. That Ye Shastra, it can, Ye has to be Dirga.
Dirga,
Ye is a long vowel.
Mm-hmm.
So, Ye Shastra, Ye, you have to take two mantras for it. Ye Shastra, the time you take for Shastra, the same time you have to take for Ye. Ye Shastra.
Both Dirga.
Yeah.
Ye Shastra.
Yeah. Those are the two points for Vega. You can go to the next person.
Yeah. Yes.
Thank you. Hariom.
Thank you very much.
Yana, пожалуйста. It's Yana next.
Yana is here.
I also like the second one, but Anatoly just took it, so I could repeat it or recite any shloka you chose.
Sure, Yana. I mean, what you memorized, you can recite. What
you
is
can it? Repeat it.
There
you
are only repeat. Nine. We don't have much choice.
I could do any, but it's okay. I'll do second.
Okay, fine. Sure.
Only because I like.
Yeah, sure.
Sri Bhagavan Uvacha Trividha Bhavati Shraddha Dehinam Sasvabhavaja Sattviki Rajasi Cheva Tamasi Cheti Tam Shrunu.
Very good. Now, can we go for the fourth one? Yajante.
Yajante Sattvika Devan. Yaksharaksham sirajasah pretan bhutaganam chanye yajante tamasajanah.
Very good. Dhanyavadaha. So, the feedback for the first shloka memorization is The second line, all the dirghas, Satviki came out well, but Rajasi and Tamasi also should come out well. Satviki, Rajasi, Chaiva, Tamasi, Cheti, Tamasi, Rajasi. That dirgha has to come out well. That was one feedback from my side for that shloka. Usha's feedback, we will ask her. Then for the fourth shloka, the second line again. Pretan bhuta ganashchanye. So how do we do that? There are two options for that. One is ganan cha anye. So ganashchanye or ganamshchanye. So we close the mouth, ganamshchanye. So two options are there, ganamshchanye. So you close the mouth after ganam, ganamshchanye, ganamshchanye, like that. So that was one major point. Balance, everything was okay for the second one. Any points?
No, same points, mine also. But I'm very happy, Anna. You are also afraid of the exam. You are not ready, but you did it very well. You did it with the good bhava that I liked most. I wanted to appreciate you on that. Yes, Mark.
Is everyone happy? We move on.
Yes. Yes, we can.
I am proud. I am not happy. I am proud of her. So it is Natasha next. Natasha.
Should see her first. Where is she? I can't find her.
I'm here.
Yeah. Okay.
Hariom.
Yeah. The melodious girl. Huh? She is a very good singer in Russian. So I mean, she loves the tunes more than the shloka and the contents. Okay, she's more on music. Okay, that's her background. Yeah. So what's the memorized shloka of yours?
Can I sing two?
Sure.
Are you? Aharasha pisaravasya trivitho bhavati priyaha yadnastapastatha danaham tesham hedam imam shrunu ayusatva balaramya sukha priti vivardhanaha Rasya snikha thira hrnya ahara sattvika priya.
Okay, good.
Okay, so seventh ahara stupi sarvasya.
If you want again, they can just say it again, Anna. There's no problem. Like if you can't make, I also have, I can't make all the points in first go, then I ask them to recite again and then where the points enter.
Regarding the second shloka, what you recited, the first shloka, if you can repeat, it will be helpful.
Ahasvapi sarvasya trivitho bhavati priyaha. Yadnastapastathadanam tesham hedam imam shrunu.
So the first line, aharas tvapi sarvasya. That tvapi is not at all heard. Aharas tvapi. Aharaha tu api. Aharas tvapi. So tvapi, it is not aharas tapi, it is aharas tvapi.
Aharas tvapi.
This is the pronunciation which is required there. So this is done. Bhava trividho bhavati priyaha. It is rasa. You are giving dirgha there, like in Rajasi. So you should not give dirgha there. So which means you should not elongate bhavati priyaha, bhavati priyaha. Can you tell that again?
Bhavati priyaha.
That's all. So that is done. That was the second point. Then yajnas tapastatha. Can you repeat that?
Yajnas tapastatha.
Ha. So that yajna. Yajna.
Yajna.
Yajna. Yajna tapastatha dhanam. Ha. That one, that correction in nya. Then tesham. Can you repeat tesham?
Tesham.
Very good. Vedamimam shrunu. Shrunu, can you tell once?
Shrunu.
Okay. That na and shr, that has to come, it has come this time when you told now, it has come out correctly.
Shrunu, I can't say r, I can't pronounce it the r.
It's problem for most of them.
Right. That was very good. So next shloka, can you repeat now? Ayusattva.
Ayusattva balarogyam sukha priti vivarandhanam rasya.
Hey, just a minute. Ayusattva is not there. Ayusattva. That is a short vowel. Balarogya. There no.
Ayusattva balarogya.
That's all. Rogya. No elongation. Rogya.
Rogya.
Ah. Sukha. And there is no visarga also. There is no dot. So balarogya. Sukha. Preeti Vivardhanaha.
Sukha Preeti Vivardhanaha.
Perfect. So those two places. Next line, Ramya. Rasya.
Rasya Snigha Thira Randya Ahara Satvika Priya.
So Satvika Priya no. Satvika priyaha. There is no elongation in ka. Satvika priyaha. And
Satvika priyaha.
And rasya snigdha stira hridya. There, rasya snigdha. You have to, that visarga, you have to pronounce it as half sakara. Rasya snigdha.
Rasya snigdha.
Rasya snigdha stira.
Rasya snigdha stira.
This is the change. Balance, everything is okay.
Yeah.
And thank you very much.
Yeah, my side, Natalia, you were like the trividha, the three was elongated and na needs improvement. And then Rasya Snigdha, Dha is not still coming good, okay? Your Dha needs, Ta has got improved, but Dha needs improvement. And that which we had discussed, the conjunct letter, that before letter will have the pause and the heaviness, that is not shown completely. It is much improved than before, I agree, but it is not yet completely audible properly, okay? That's nice.
I'll try to pay attention. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I guess we are ready for Christina.
Christina, wow, Christina, are you in the forest or you're at home?
Yes, I'm at home today.
Wow.
Hello, something wrong with my camera, just a moment.
Okay.
I'm going to sing fourth shloka.
Okay. That's
Yajante Satvika Devang Yaksha Rakshansi Rajasahang Pretang Putaganang Shchanyen Yajante Tamasa Janahang.
So, 1 minute, just give me.
No, she's not. Video is mute. One second.
Once again? What?
Сейчас, подожди, по-моему, они думают. Ты сразила всех, Христина.
Я волнуюсь ужасно. У меня с этим проблемы.
Usha, are you there? Они, видимо, совещание.
No, Anna was discussing one Ucharana issue which I was not aware before. So he says the both of them are correct, so he's going to consider it. Okay, so that's what we were discussing.
Okay. Can you repeat once?
Christina, please repeat.
Yajante Satvika Devam Yaksharakshansi Rajasaham Pretam Bhutagananshchanyen Yajante Tamasajanaham.
So the Dirghas, they are almost there. Ta Yajante Tamasajanaha. So the Dirghas can be improved in that portion. Yajante Tamasa Janaha. That portion Dirgha can be improved. Yaksharakshamsi. Actually was well told. I was worrying if that C will be Dirgha, but it was told very well. Balance were good, only that one point, maybe two places Dirgha can be taken little bit longer. Again, Pretan Bhuta Ganams Chanye. There are two options there. Bhuta Ganams Chanye, you close the mouth. Pretan Bhuta Ganams Chanye also is there, where you tell the Anunasika. But when we tell the Ye, again it is a Dirgha. Pretan, Pretan Bhuta Ganams Chanye. So, Pre and Ye. All the Ekara and Okara are Dirgha letters, which we should give two matras for them, and we should not hurry up in pronouncing them. That's it.
And yeah, my side, Christina, Ganansh Chanye Dharna was Raswa. Okay, it needs the Dirgha, and Chanye, the Cha, was also Raswa. So it should be elongated more, right? And you are holding, Christina. This is like we had worked it out. You were very well coming till last week. You are doing it with a holding. I want you to recite with full heart. I mean, you are a wonderful reciter. You have been experiencing this from a long time. So I don't expect this from you. So please come back again. I mean, I want you to recite once again that same shloka without holding. Okay, I want you to hear your perfect voice, right?
Марс Юрьевич, в двух словах.
Ты готова еще раз без нервничания и без задержек?
Ну, я попробую. Правда, я не поняла, что там я сделала коротким, а что длинным. Ну, ладно.
Иногда тебя просят тянуть чуть больше.
Ага.
Тяни.
Яджанте сатвика деван. Yaksharakshamsi Rajasaham Pretam Bhutagananshchanye Yajante Tamasajanaham.
Yeah, this is better.
This is full. This has come out very well. I am sure everybody else also will agree.
Yeah, yes.
Good. This is perfect, nice. Christina.
Thank you. I just found ground under my legs and
next student, yeah.
Next is Olga, the teacher of the teacher.
Yeah, yes. Olga, welcome.
Hello.
She's here. We can't see her because of the Skype limitation, so she's there.
I'm here.
Yeah.
What is her name?
Olga. Your video is not seen in my Skype, Olga, unfortunately.
But I can see here from mine. That means at least it's there.
It's there in the recording, yeah, I'm sure.
Right.
So memorize the shloka first.
Well, I try to memorize all of them, so probably you should tell me which I should.
Wow, that's great.
Okay. Sixth shloka. Karshayantas sharirastham.
Karshayantah sharirastham bhutagrama chetasah mam chayvantah sharirastham tan vidhya sura nishchayan.
Continue. Next. Should I give the lead or you can continue straight? One after the other.
Aharastvati sarvasya trividho bhavati priyaha yajnastapastathadanam tesham bhedamimam shrunu.
Suppose I give a word, can you recite from there? Can you try?
Yes, I can try.
You can try. So let me give a word. Tikshna.
Tikshna ruksha vidahinaha ahara rajasa syeshka dukha shokamaya pradaha.
So excellent, very good.
Very good.
Thank you.
This is amazing. This is amazing. I can't believe my eyes and ears.
Okay. So just to tell everybody, this is how the memorization test is conducted in India. So we ask the words, etc. So there are people in the United States who are doing the recitation of Gita. They memorized a full 18 chapter, 700 shlokas in 1 year. In 1 year, they memorized the full 700 shlokas. It is not a joke. I will share you the videos of those children and the teacher who has taught them. I will share it to Usha and she will share it to you in the group. This is not for comparison. This is just getting inspired from seeing divine children. Not for comparison. Please don't compare them with this one. There is no comparison. The Lord has created all of us with the same Chaitanya. The Chaitanya Shakti in you and in me and in Usha and in Mark. Everybody in Natasha, in Olga, in Vega, everything, everybody is same. So we should not compare ourselves, first point. But it is, we can get inspired by those children. So those children, I just want to share this because this is a monotonous thing. Those children, I conducted the test for them last month. So that was entire 700 shlokas of Gita. Okay, I was invited by them. I ask any shloka, they tell any shloka from the Gita, they continue. I ask any word, they continue from there. Now there were few children who could tell, if I tell them 18th chapter, 18th shloka, they will tell the shloka. If I tell 15th chapter, 11th shloka, they will give Delta Laham Vaishwanaro Bhutva Sarvasya Chaham. They will tell the shloka. That was one kind of children. There was one kind of children who used to solve puzzles. That was very interesting. What they used to do is, I used to tell them the sixth word. For example, let us take this shloka, ninth shloka. Katvamla 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So the ninth letter is T. Okay. I tell them the ninth letter is T. Then I tell the first letter is the third letter or the fourth letter is La. Then I tell in the second line there is Hara is there. Ahara, Hara is there. Now that boy or that girl, she completes the puzzle and tells the shloka. So I give them only 3 to 5 clues in a shloka and they tell the entire thing. So now all of you might be thinking, why this memorization is required? Why is this memorization being told in India like so many times? In India, the tradition says that, especially our Vedic tradition, it tells us that we have to internalize something before we experience something. Okay, we have to internalize something, be it behavior, be it knowledge. So the first step that is advised by our tradition is Shravanam. Shravanam is listening. So you have to listen to the words 100 times, 200 times. You have to listen to the chant. When you listen to the chant, your brain will start thinking, what is this I am listening? Is it just a music or a sound, or does it have some meaning? Then you will come up with that question and you will ask that question to your teacher. Now, when you ask that question to the teacher, then the teacher will tell you, this is the meaning of the word. Now, there may be situations when you know the meaning, but you forget the word itself, the moola itself. The moola, or the moola, has got some power. Chanting Sanskrit shlokas has got immense power. It has the effect of pranayama. It has the effect of all the yogic practices like Kapalabhati, Nadi Shodha. All these pranayama effects are there. So myself and my brother, we have given a lecture on power of Sanskrit, in which also Usha will share. This was given in the United States when we traveled there. So you can refer to those lectures and understand the power of only chanting. Now, I was coming to the processes how these shlokas are learned. The first step is Shravanam, which I said is listening. The second step is Mananam. So after you listen, you will ask, what is the meaning? The teacher will tell you the meaning. Once you know the meaning, you will start internalizing the meaning in your body and in your mind. So this internalization happens at different levels. Now, there are pancha kosha in our sharira: annamaya, pranamaya, vijnanamaya, manomaya, anandamaya kosha. Usha will sometime talk to you about these pancha koshas. Now, the chanting will help the at least three levels. It helps you at three levels. Then when you internalize the shloka, it helps you at your vijnanamaya kosha, manomaya kosha, and vijnanamaya kosha. That means there are five layers in your body. This body is not only the physical body. The body, the breath, the manas, the mind, then you have the knowledge sheath, and then the bliss or the happiness sheath. So in order to experience this ananda at all levels, memorization, the first step is Shravanam, listening. The second step is Mananam, in which memorizing, knowing the meaning, and then internalizing it in your life. Then Nididhyasanam, the third step is Nididhyasanam, where you will start implementing that shloka in your life. So now suppose it talks about Aharastvapi Sarvasya Trividha. This chapter talks about three types of food that we can take, and it talks about Sattvika food, it talks about Rajasika food, that is 8 and 9, and it tells you what kind of food we should eat and what is the effect it has got on the mind. Now, once you have understood the meaning, you have chanted the shloka, you will implement this in your life also, where you will think, let me consider those types of food which give me energy to think about the Paramatma, the universal force which is binding this world. So we should consume those foods which augment our vitality, our energy, our strength, our health, which keeps us cheerful, and which takes care of our appetite, and which is substantial, and which is agreeable. Patya, which is agreeable to the body. If you eat more oily food, we become fat, we become obese. If you eat more liquid food, we become very thin. Then, so we should take care of ourselves. only when we, so these are kind of concepts being told in the 17th chapter in the 8th and the 9th shloka. So this kind of thinking will come when you internalize, and in the third step, when you start thinking, should I do this in my life? Should I practice this Gita shloka in my life? That is the third step of Gita chanting. That is, we internalize this shloka. Any time when we get a doubt, it is not, we should not refer the book. We should have it in our mind. We should have internalized it in such a way that it becomes a part and parcel of our life. So that is why in our tradition, we give importance to chanting and shravanam, listening, and memorizing. I hope you all understand this. You have to experience this once. With the 17th chapter, you can experience this. And 17th chapter is such a chapter which you can implement straight away in your lives. I am sure Usha ji will tell you how to implement it in your further classes. And it is a beautiful chapter which we can implement. Suppose she had taken 12th or 15th chapter, it would have been very difficult to implement. You need a different level of mind to implement that in your daily life. It may take years to implement. But the 17th chapter has got 3-4 shlokas which we will definitely implement. For example, the 10th shloka says we should not eat stale and bad food. Yatayamam gatarasam putam paryushitam chayat. We should not keep it in the refrigerator and eat it after 2 days, 3 days, as per the Gita. So we should prepare freshly the food and eat it immediately within 2 hours. So I'm just giving you one tip regarding the food that we can implement. So it may be in the foreign countries, the culture is that we keep it in the refrigerator and eat the food. But we can reduce it and see the effect on our body when we do two types of, when we follow Gita and when we don't follow Gita. So then you can see the difference, and if it is making a positive impact in your body, mind, then implement it and feel happy about it. That is the final fruit of Gita, which is why it has to be implemented, which is why these are the stages of learning: Shravanam, Mananam, Nididhyasanam. I would request all of you to repeat this: Shravanam, Mananam,
Vidhyasanam.
These three steps we can follow. Now we will go to the next person. Sorry for taking time, but this was, I thought this message has to be given sometime. That is why we are very particular about this pronunciation. You can always say, see, I am having a very good bhava expression. I really respect the Supreme Force. The bhava is there in your heart, but that bhava has to be expressed in the right way, in the right proportion, in the right in the right method, and that has to be come in. It has to come out through your body, your voice, etc. That is kayena vacha manasa. It has to come out in all aspects.
Thank you. Right. Nice.
Thank you.
17th chapter, the relevance. Yeah. So now you know more importance, and now you'll be happier in chanting. And
For Olga, I think we have to just give her the pronunciation tips. I would request her to tell one more shloka so that we can give her the tips. That sattvanurupa sarvasya. Third shloka.
Sattvanurupa sarvasya. Shraddha bhavati bharata. Shraddha mayoyam purusho. Yoya shraddha saeva saha.
Very good. So again, purusho, there all the dirghas, that okara and ekara dirghas, again we have to purusho yo shraddha mayoyam. So there are three dirghas there, which has to be pronounced properly. Balance bhavati Shraddha Bhavati Bharata. So that Mahapranas have to come little more better. It should come in a very good way. Yoyak Shraddha. That this one is there, no? That cha. Yoyak Shraddhasa Evasaha. That Mahaprana also should come. The stress in the breath also should increase. Then only the effect of the pronunciation will be there. Thank you, Olga.
Thank you. It was good, Olga. My side also the same points, right?
Thank you.
Mark.
It's Ludmila Mayer.
Oh, Ludmila Mayer, is she there? Yeah, she's here. Ludmila, Hari Om. We can't see her.
Namaste, Hari Om.
Namaste, Hari Om.
I memorized first shloka.
Yeah, fourth one?
Yours.
I didn't understand. Yeah, please recite.
Arjuna Vacham Yesha Stravidhimut Srinjyam Yajante Shrathayan Vitaham Tesham Nishthatuka Krishna Satvamaho Rajastamaha.
So 2 points for Ludmila. Arjuna Uvacha. Arjuna Uvacha, again that au sound is being heard. Arjuna Uvacha. Then we have ye, again ye shastram, that ye yajante, that dirga, tesham nishthatu ka Krishna. I think she told that. You have told correctly. Only 2 points. Ye yajante ye Arjuna vacha.
Shall we have one more, or we can?
Do you want to do one more, Ludmila, or you want to? You are happy with this?
I can do another one.
You can do another one. Then ninth shloka.
Katvam lalavana tyushnam Tikshna ruksha vidahinaham ahara rajasa sishtam dukha shoka maya pradaha.
This requires some practice, this shloka. Dukha shoka maya prada. The du, after du you have the visarga. So there are two schools of thought. You don't pronounce the visarga there, dukkha. Then another school of thought is dukkha. You pronounce it little bit. So in South India, we pronounce that little bit. Dukkha, shoka, maya, pradaha. So that is 1 point. Then katvam la lavana tyushna. We have to sharpen that. It has to come out more open. And tikshna ruksha vida vidahinaha. That portion did not come out well.
Yeah. Ludmila, the ta came out when you say katvamla. It is a ta. It is the murdhanya, the cerebral ta. Okay. Instead of that, the dental ta came out. Okay. So that's one thing. So that's the only thing I wanted to know. Rest was all fine. The sha and everything came fine.
Is there anything else to be said, or we move on to Leela?
We move on?
Yeah, we move on.
Leela,
okay?
We move on. Hari Om.
Hari Om, Leela. Let me find you first. Yeah, you are here.
Тебя не видно? Не вижу только я?
I'm very unhappy with Skype today. I can't see even one
person. Yes, Didi. It's very bad today. It's, I would say, miserable today.
Leela, Hari Om Leela, yeah. You can tell your memorized shloka. Well, I like the most the fifth shloka.
Yes.
Ashastra vihitam ghoram tapyante yetapo janah dambhahankara samyuktah kamara gabalambitah.
Beautiful. Beautiful. So, dambahankara sanyuktaha. So, there are two options there. Because of that anusara being present, samyuktaha is one option. Sanyuktaha is one option. So, both options can be told, except that I don't have any point. You have told it correctly.
No holding and la came very well. Everything was perfect, Leela.
Thank you.
Leela, are you an Indian or you are a Russian?
Leela, she is a Russian. She has named herself.
Yeah, I'm Ukrainian.
Okay.
We move on?
Yes.
Yes, because Leela was perfect.
Great. Great to hear that. Then next is Anna. Is Anna there?
Yeah, Anna.
Yes, I'm here. Yes. Namaste. Namaskar, Usha.
Namaskar. Yes. So yeah, please come ahead with your memorized shloka.
So I've memorized first six. I could do fourth.
Fourth. Okay.
Yajante satvika devam yakshorakshasi rajasaham Pretam bhutaganashchanye yajante tamasajana.
So, can you repeat the first line, please?
Sorry?
First line,
can you repeat?
Of course. Mm-hmm. Yajante satvika devam. Yaksharakshansi rajasaham pretan bhutaganashchanye yajante tamasajanam.
Okay, so yeah, slightly you can open pronunciation can be done more open. Your shloka is good. Suppose I ask you to pronounce, tell it with more energy. Can you tell it again?
Yeah, I'm very emotional. That's why I lose my voice where I'm worried. I'm emotional.
Okay. So what is happening is the words are getting
crushed, crumbled.
Crumbled. It is not coming out with full energy.
I know you can do better, Anna. Please.
If you can try again, we'll be very happy.
The same?
Same,
Yajante satvika devan yaksharakshansi rajasam pretan bhutaganaschanye yajante tamasajanah.
Beautiful.
Much better. Yes.
So pretan bhuta, that pretan bhuta, that can be slightly improved. Pretan bhuta.
Bhuta ganastanye.
That can be improved slightly, and yajante is correct, but devan yaksharakshamsi, that C is a hraswa. So tamasa janaha, that also, that dirga can be slightly elongated. So these are the points. Do you want to do one more
shloka? Yeah,
sure.
Which one?
Tell me your.
Okay, so I would prefer 9.
9.
Katvam lalavanat yushnat tikshna ruksha vidahinaha ahara rajasa syeshta dukha shoka maya pradaha.
Okay. So this is good. Again, that katvam lalavana tyushna. Tyushna.
Katvam lalavana tyushna.
So that portion can be slightly improved, but it came out well. Balance, everything is okay.
So Rakshamsi was very beautiful, Anna. I really liked it. You worked a lot, I know. And she can go out of the tune sometimes, but she pronunciation, she holds very well.
Okay.
Yeah. So she compromises with the tune for the pronunciation. I like it very
right.
much.
Right.
Thank you. Thank you, Anna. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Are we good to go?
Yes.
Инна, тебя в списке нету, но ты же не пройдешь мимо. Инна, слышишь ли ты меня?
Инна.
У Инны отключен просто микрофон, поэтому я не слышу, что она, даже если бы она попыталась сказать.
Вы меня спрашиваете, Марк?
Да, здесь только одна Инна, ты не поверишь, ты единственная, уникальная.
Ну, я это ничего не готовила, конечно, пришла послушать.
Хорошо, но ты же готова зачитать нам, хотя бы прочитать то, что ты посчитаешь возможным?
Maybe after two or three sessions, she attended. Any memorized shloka, Inna?
No, she is bad with memorization, but she is ready to read it.
Fine. So okay. You were present after the seventh shloka, I remember. The sixth or seventh?
Seventh,
right. So please recite the seventh shloka.
I will try.
Aharastva
pisarvasya trivitho bhavati priya yajnatapastathadanam Desham Pedam Imanshunu. Sorry. I already in the future.
I'm very happy that you're participating in the exam, though you're not ready. We all know about your condition, but still you participated inside the shloka. We are happy. Don't worry about the result, okay? Your participation.
We will not put marks for
you. Yeah, we'll not put marks for you. Your participation itself is the marks, okay?
Oh, thank you.
Then
next person.
We can go for Jana. Jana.
Yeah. So where is she? Let me find her. Jana. Jana.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.
So this portion of reciters, they are newcomers. They have attended not more than five classes. And actually, their background is Devanagari classes, so they are not advanced in any level compared to the old school reciters that were before. So here come the newcomers.
Okay. Which shloka?
So which shloka are you going to tell, Jana?
The ninth shloka.
Ninth.
Tvam lalavanat yushna tikhna ruksha vidahinaha ahara rajasa syeshta dukha shoka maya pradaha.
Unbelievable.
Thank you. Very nice. Dukha, can you repeat the second line?
Ahara rajasa syeshta dukha shoka maya pradaha.
Dukha, that dukha, you can pronounce better.
Dukha.
That is how you have to pronounce. And Shoka again is Dirga. Shoka Maya Pradaha. And when you are doing Maya Pradaha,
Maya Pradaha. Maya Pradaha.
I have told a letter before conjunct letter, then you have to give pause and wait.
Pause, wait, and stress.
Stress, yeah.
Maya. Shoka Maya Pradaha.
So I used to tell Mayap Pradaha. Like that, you said that. So Mayap Pradaha. The year should have more weight.
It's good. Very good pronunciation.
Yeah, no, but lot of holding is there. Okay, the holding should go away. Your fear is bringing the holding, so that should go away, right?
We are so impressed. We didn't hear any holding or side, Usha.
You are very optimistic. I know.
Thank you.
Thank you, Shana.
Are we ready to move on?
Yes.
Left it out.
Yeah, Leo, I think. Leo. Unmute yourself, please.
Yes, I see him muted. Lev, ты слышишь нас?
Leo.
Mark, please tell his name perfectly once again. I always call him Leo.
His name is Lev. Lev.
Simha. In Sanskrit, Simha, my name is.
Simha.
Simha, yeah.
Leo.
It's in Russia, Lev, in Sanskrit, Simha.
So you have memorized shloka.
Okay, I prepare three shlokas memorized. Number 7, number 8, and number 9. I can recite the...
Okay. 8 and 9.
Okay.
8 and 9.
Okay. Аюсатва баларогья сукхапритиви вардханаха расьях сникхах стхирахырдья ахара сатвика прияха катвам лалавана тюшна Тикшна рукша видахинаха, ахара раджья састьешта, духа шока моя прадаха.
Very nice, Лев. So
he is also comparatively new, but he has been systematically, since he started, he has been systematically covered.
Second line in the 8th shloka, rasya snigdha sthira.
Okay.
So you have to half sa between the two words. Sthira. Can you repeat that?
Yes. Rasya sthira. Расьяс снигдхас стхира хырдья.
Okay, that was the correction. That was the correction which you have to make. Then хырдья, if you are хырдья, so the visarga here. Хырдья,
we are not.
So хырдья ахараха сатвика прияха, that сатвика also. That stress should be there on the, not on the breath, but on the ta. Sattvika priyaha, sattvika priyaha. That stress is required.
Sattvika priyaha.
That only one. Those are the two points in the 8th shloka. In the 9th shloka, what you are telling? Katvamla lavanatyushna. So, tikshna ruksha. Vidahinaha, that vidahinaha can be better.
Vidahinaha. Vidahinaha.
Dukkha, and the second line, dukkha, shokamai, dukkha.
Dukkha, dukkha.
Dukkha. Dukkha-shokamaya
pradaha.
Beautiful. That's all. Those are the corrections.
The kat bangla datta should come more prominently, and there is lot of holding the la and the na. They are being holded more. Okay. And the dirghas should be reworked. You are the comparatively new reciter. So we are not taking it too seriously for you. Okay. Your memorizing itself and your presenting itself was very remarkable and nice. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Move on.
Yes.
Then it's Larissa.
Yeah. Larissa, she's more new. I mean, she's just 2 or 3 classes she came. where is she? I don't find her.
I see her.
Namaste.
Yeah, namaste. So how are you?
7 or 8 shloka.
7 shloka. Yes, yes. Please recite.
Bhavati priyaha yajnastapasthada tathadanam tesham phedam imam shrunu.
Perfect.
Ayu.
Yeah, please go on. Yeah. Continue, please.
Vayuh sattva bala rogya sukha priti vivardhana rasyah snidhah sthirah ridya ahara sattvika priya.
You are telling it out of memory, Larissa?
I'm... Little.
Okay, you have seen it and said, right? Mm-hmm. So we are unable
Larissa, to see the video. Larissa, ты читала или ты заучила? Или смешанно?
Смешанно.
So she memorized it, but every time memory got bad, she looked in the book.
Okay.
Okay, no problem. So... That is where the holding is there. When she thinks she has lost her memory, her attention is getting diverted, which is what is a point. Then the first shloka, Trividho Mahaprana and Okara Dirga, both should come. Trividho Bhavati Priyaha. Bhavati Priyaha. So it has to come out very clearly. That was not very clear. The clarity was lacking. Bhavati Priyaha.
Trividho Bhavati Priyaha.
Now it is okay. Tesham Belana. This is okay. Second line of 8th shloka, Rasya Snigdha Sthira Hridyaha, that portion. Can you repeat?
Rasya Sthira
Snigdha
Rasya Snigdha Sthira Hridyaha.
Go ahead.
Ahara sattvika priyaha.
Ahara sattvika priyaha.
This time it's better.
Yeah, this time it is okay. So, but you can practice more is what? More open pronunciation. The voice box has to open a lot.
Yeah, she's comparatively new, and third needs a lot of improvement. Okay, so you're going to do it. We'll do it together, right? It's too early for you to be judged. So please take it as a good way of participating. That good spirit, please keep it up, right? Nice.
Dhanyavada.
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 Роза, тут ли ты?
Yeah, Rosa. Rosa is coming and going, coming and going, coming and going.
Yes, she is coming and going because Skype is going mad today.
Right, I know.
I'm trying to understand if she's here.
Hari Om. Yeah. So please come ahead with your memorized shloka.
Do you hear me? Yeah.
Yes.
Тебя слышно хорошо.
Yeah, хорошо.
Okay. The same way as Lev, I have prepared three shlokas, the last three, 7, 8, and 9. Right. So I can recite any of them.
Right.
So 8 and 9?
8 and 9.
Okay. sorry. Ayu sattva bala rogya sukha prithivi vardhanaha rasyah Nikhah kira hrdya ahara sattvika priyaha. I'm nervous a little bit, I'm sorry.
No problem, please.
No issues. When we told the shloka first time, I told the shloka first time when I was in 7th standard at the age of 12. So what happened was, I'll just narrate that incident. So I had learned Gita from my grandfather. So my father took me to a teacher and said that he knows Gita. And the teacher on that day was conducting a Gita competition. And it was 12th chapter. The teacher said, why, if you know Gita and 12th chapter, why don't you compete? Why don't you recite? Why don't you chant? The way I am testing you, I was tested by the teacher without any notice. When I was in my 7th standard, 7th standard age 12 years. So I got nervous, and I was more nervous than Rosa today. I had my hearted in my house and all those things. But there suddenly the teacher is asking, you have my hearted now. Now you please recite. So I got the same place in the competition at that time. But I was so nervous, and it was evident in my voice. So everybody is nervous. We all have to cross the stages. So it is not that only Rosa was nervous today. Somebody else would have been nervous when they had practiced. Now they have overcome their nervous because they have come out of that stage. That's it. So now, coming back to the shloka. Can we, she told both.
She told, no, one she said.
Can you tell, ninth also, did you tell Rosa? I'm just unable to
read. Not yet.
Yeah, ninth she has not told. Can you tell the ninth?
I can repeat the previous one, and I can the ninth shloka again.
Yeah, you can repeat if you want, or you can tell the ninth also. Whatever you want, you can do.
May I repeat, please?
Please.
Аю саттва бала ругья сукха притиви варданаха расьях сникхах хирах рдья ахара саттвика прияха.
So we need some practice in pronunciation. At this moment, I will not put any mark on the pronunciation. I will only mark the memory and bhava expression in your case. So, rasya, snigdha, sthira, hridyaha, aharasa. That full line needs some improvement in the pronunciation. The expression bhava was very good. The memory was good. Excellent. Now you can go to the ninth shloka.
Okay. Katva katva la lavana tyushna tikshna ruksha vidahinagah ahara rajasyashta sukha shoka maya pradaha.
Very good. So the pronunciation needs some improvement and practice. So we have to look at the letters and the conjunct letters, their pronunciation a little bit.
Yeah.
I think after two or three practice sessions, maybe we can do it better. But your expression was good. Your bhava, bhakti, or the devotion to the recitation was good. Your memory was also good. You have practiced well. Your memory is there. So you only have to sharpen the pronunciation a little bit.
Okay, thank you.
Then I am asking another Lyudmila, Lyudmila Tutlity.
She is here.
Yeah. What is
her name? Yes.
Да. Что ты готова?
Я сразу начну петь, иначе у меня голос будет пропадет.
Хорошо.
Аюсат. Два бала рогья, сухо прийти виватхана, разъяснить хатхира хрдья, ахара сатвика прия, катвам лалаванат юшнага, тикшна рукша видахинага. Ахара раджаса съештага, дукха шока моя продага. Вот, с ошибками.
Окей.
Я еще две учила, но боюсь, уже голос мне пропадет.
Да не, не надо, куда же.
It was хорошо, окей, don't worry.
Окей, so regarding the pronunciation, the expression was there. I think it was there. Rasyas, Nigdhas, that portion again. Needs some practice. And Katvam la Ravana Tikshna. Can you repeat that once?
Repeat, okay. Katvam la Ravana Tikshna. Tikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha. Ахара раджаса съештага, дукха шока моя продага.
So, катвам ла лавана тюшна, there is no дирга there. It is not a long vowel. So, катвам ла лавана тюшна.
Катвам ла лавана тюшна.
That one Hraswa Dirga differentiation. Tikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha.
Tikshna Ruksha Vidahinaha.
This is the correction which we have to make. And in the second line, Dukha Shoka Mayapradaha.
Dukha shoka maya pradaha.
Okay.
So when in practice you all are saying that conjunct letter before letter perfectly, but in the exam everyone is missing it. I have observed that, right? So that is the one point. I mean, after, like, while repeating you are saying it perfectly, but by yourself when you are left, you are doing for the first time, then it is not coming good. Okay. That needs an improvement. Everybody. Almost
the nerves seem to show some
right
difference.
Yeah. So this did not have enough practice. I agree that, right, the newcomers could not have more practice of these things. The older ones are much better in this. Okay, so there's markedly difference. There's marked difference in that. No problem.
Let me see if we have somebody missing. Seems to be that all are there, but let me see. Есть ли кто-нибудь, кого я забыл, или кто есть, но не было в списке? И кто готов? Оля, видишь ли ты кого-нибудь, кого... Просто я не всех вижу, поэтому я спрашиваю. Вроде все,
ну,
есть,
кажется,
да?
Никого не осталось. Все.
Мне тоже кажется, что все были. Хорошо. Диди, it means all have been there.
Right.
And, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good, good, nice. So the exam is complete here, right?
Right.
Thank
you. Didi, it's your time. It's your turn. Now you say.
So yeah, the same holding in the new students, only the new students, all students are all good. I have seen not much problems, only some holding was there and they all did with happiness with the preparation. I'm really happy to see you all smiling and presenting your shlokas, right? So that's the one thing. And the new students really need a lot of improvement. That's my, we could not have much time to spend together. So that's not their fault. So please don't feel bad that you could not do well, or please don't worry about your mistakes, right? We will overcome those mistakes very soon, right? With our practice, we'll do it, okay? So not much to say except the holding. I don't want that holding anymore. You should recite with free mind, with happiness, as Anna said in the beginning itself, okay? So you're singing for the Bhagavan, you're singing for the Lord. So you should remember that Bhagavan and then sing, right? So that's the one thing we should cultivate. What Anna said, many, many good points are there for us. Even from my learning, it was there. So some pronunciations, I had doubts, they were got cleared, right? And Rasya, Snigdha, there I had taught you with Avisarga. So I will correct myself from the next time. So it's a lot of improvement. It's a slow process, step by step that we move, okay? So I did not get chance to correct myself. Now I get chance. So I'm a student as well here. In this exam, I had much to learn, right? So it's a collective experience. It was a wonderful time that we spent together. I'm happy. Please don't be disappointed or expecting anything out of this exam. It's not for your certification. It's not for your evaluation. It's just an experience that we want to undergo with happiness, with a welcome. Okay, that's all. Please don't consider these marks anywhere. We will practice. We will have good time of improvement. Okay, and everybody on getting repetition. When you are repeating, you are doing it perfectly. Okay, that's one good thing that I found. Okay, so nothing much to add.
So I first congratulate Mark and the entire team here who are participating in this satsanga. Satsanga is you are having good time. Satvika, you are spending your time in the right way by learning something which is very significant, which can transform your lives, which is the Gita. So I congratulate everybody for spending this time, and I congratulate and I am very jealous of Usha that she has got such nice students such nice students sometimes are not available in India also.
Yes.
I am very, very open. I have been a teacher for the past 28 years myself. More than 28 to 30 years I have taught Sanskrit and Gita and all these things. I have been a teacher for 28 years. Such sincere students I have never seen. They are very rare. There are students, but they are very rare to find. So two actions from my side is I have to forward the link of those students in America who have chanted the Gita. I would request you to go through that. There is a Facebook live page link which we will forward to you. That is just for inspiration. The second link is the Power of Sanskrit, which link which we will send, wherein you can listen to that lecture given by me and my brother. Maybe my brother would have spoken about chanting. So you can go through that chanting related transformation which will happen in your lives when you chant Gita or any Sanskrit shlokas. So you can read those two for further reading. I would request you all to continue this Gita journey in learning the Gita, and also may the Supreme Force help you to memorize all the 700 shlokas and take you through the journey of Shravanam, Mananam and Nididhyasanam. So thank you very much. There is also one Gita Vidya Parishad in Germany, which is promoting Gita for the Europe. So I will also connect that person with Mark first. I will introduce, there is a person called Gopi Gloman, who conducts this Gita Vidya Parishad. He has some shlokas from Gita which he teaches to all the Europeans. And this is there in Europe, especially in Germany, he is doing it. So I would introduce that Gita Sadhaka course or something which is there, which has about 100 shlokas out of 700, which if we master first, you can understand. So I will connect Mark first with him, and then I will take Mark and Gopi Gloman will talk, and then you can see what is useful for you. And with guidance from Usha, you can take that for if it is applicable and if it is helpful, useful for you. The most important thing is we should study the language, which is Sanskrit, to understand Gita well. Without the translation, you have to understand the Sanskrit language very well. So that will help you in your second stage of learning, which is mananam, the meaning. So though there are translations available in Russian language and in all the languages of the world, still reading it in original will actually have a great difference and an impact. So I would encourage all of you to study Sanskrit as well, and if possible, the Devanagari script, if possible. Dhanyavada. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mark, for giving me such an opportunity to interact with these great people. I would call them great because their Chaitanya is so pure. Their heart is so pure that they are coming to this satsang and learning this supreme knowledge.
I hope it is not the last time. I hope we can repeat it, let's say, once per half a year. I hope, if you do not mind, I would love to see you visit us, and we would love to get the guidance which we lack otherwise.
Sure, Mark. It is my pleasure to be with these students and lovely people. Thank you for introducing such great satsang people.
Yeah. Didi, is there something, or we are ready for the Varnamala?
Yes, we are ready for the Varnamala. Yes, we can A I I U R L U E I O U M A K K G G N C C J J N Y T T D D N T T D D N A P H A B A B H A M A Yara la va shesha saha A a I I U U R R L U E I O O M A K K G G N C C J J N T T D D N Tatha dadhana papha babha ma yara lava shesha saha.
Thanks, Lord. My heart is full of happiness today. I'm really fulfilled. Wonderful session has happened. That which started is scratch, not knowing what to do, how to face. I was so dumb at that time. Mark helped me a lot. He was a very good organizer since the beginning. And we all met each other. We all could see, which could have happened in 2013. Got possible in 2020. So I'm very happy for this. This is a very great moment in my life. Thank you so much for making it possible to each one. I really thank you.
Dhanyavad, Usha.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hariom.
Извините. У меня я запись веду. У меня микрофон завис.
А я тут сейчас что-то микрофон завис.
Ты видишь? Я даже не могу войти звонка.